And good Monday evening to you, everybody. Hello, hello. How are ya? Thanks for popping in and watching the Midwest Miniature Guy Manic Miniature Monday show. Hope you've all had a good Monday. Mine was interesting. Not going to go into it, but it's fine. Just odd. Everything's odd. Everything's weird. Welcome to the apocalypse. I don't know. It's been an interesting day. So, thank you all for being here. I greatly appreciate it. And we're just going to hop right into it and start up with hopefully getting finished with this thing tonight. I think that'd be pretty cool. I've got like 5 colors here that we're going to use. And we're going to hopefully finish up getting all these little accessories painted up. Got some green, got some, I'll have some pink. Oh, that's right, I should just grab that pink. And then we're also gonna do, we gotta do the base. And we still gotta do the rest of the candles, too. So, grab that, and a couple different yellows here. All right, so first things first, I grabbed some water from my wet palette because it dried out, I think. Oh no, we should add some in there. Oh, we're all right, we're okay, we're good. I think I'm gonna do the blue here first. Try and get this into the camera. We used some Leviathan blue, but now I want to make this more like a lighter blue here. We're just going to grab a little bit of this. That seems like too much. There. Just going to put this right over our Leviathan blue. Like so. I should grab some white. So if I want to make it look like it's a jar, we're going to need some shiny parts to it. That's a pretty good start for right now. And then we're going to grab some golden yellow here. And we're going to use this a couple of different ways. First way is on this little yellow jar here. It covers very nicely. That's nice. I like that. So I covered that little jar up pretty nicely. Can you guys, why is this not, I don't hold it up that far, come on. Go here. There we go. So hold everything right about here. I'm also going to use this for our candles. Seems like too much again. And to be honest, I still don't know how I'm going to do that OSL. I really don't. I'm not good at it. And I don't want to mess up what I've already done. Like I said, I'm not good at OSL. At least I can say that. Well, I'm not good at that. I've done like two or three models that have had some OSL on them, and only one has really turned out well, and that was like a little halfling with a glowy sword. Because this would be a lot, because I have reflections coming off of a metallic bronze egg flashing all over the model. I'm not sure if I want that or not. I'm just not sure if I want that. I know that I want some nice yellow candles, though. And of course, if you have any questions, please feel free to put them in the chat. I would love to answer them. Anything about painting or gaming, kind of life in general too, I can try. Or just chat and get to know the people that are in the stream. I'd love to build up a nice little neighborhood of people. On this channel, that'd be fun. I've been doing this Twitch channel now for 2.5 years. I mean, 280 followers, that's pretty darn good. For 2.5, you know. For a while there, I was only streaming like one or two times a week. Now I'm up to 3. I know they're like, oh, you've got to be streaming more than that. Unfortunately, with my regular day job work schedule, along with family life, I can really only do Sunday, Monday, Wednesdays. Because then I got other stuff I want to do, man. I got a game night on Thursday nights, and sometimes my band has a gig on Friday or Saturday, so I want to keep those open. What do you think of those candles? Kind of like them. All right, I'm gonna grab some green here. Sure, yeah, it's all clogged up. Wearing my designated miniature painting t-shirt tonight. I might as well get my other colors out here too. Get my red. Sure. With a clogged up one. Might as well keep this out. Pink's okay. Yep, there we go. And our candlelight yellow. I'm just going to go ahead and grab this pink here. We're going to get that finished up. I'm just going to do little swirly gigs right here. Some of that dark pink in the recesses there. Come on in. The stream is fine. So there we are. Little pink potion going on there. Green. This is actually kind of just a pouch, but there's something definitely inside of it that's causing it to have those lines, those facets. Just this little, if you can see it, it's this little pouch right here. got another. What I want to do here, though, I want to keep that kind of greenish color. This, what I want to do here is I want to grab a little bit of yellow and mix this. This kind of a glassy look on this potion here. Something like that. And I think I want to grab this candlelight yellow here. Just give this a little bit of an extra pop. It's a little bit brighter than the golden yellow. That's why we're going to use it over here. Trying to keep this in the camera. Then for the red, we got some nice brilliant red here. We're gonna do the little glass jar first. Bookmark. So, and then we're going to take a little bit of candlelight yellow here, a little bit of red, gets a nice kind of reddish orange. Mix that well. just going to go just like this. Sorry. Just like this. Put more of an orangey hue on the healing potion here. There we go. Now we're going to add a little bit more yellow into our green. Now that that's dry, we can go ahead and we can do some little streaky streak stuff here. Just like so. This still mixed up at all. Yeah, there's still a little bit of white in there. This is actually polished bone, but it's a nice off-white. I think it'll work pretty good for giving me a nice, little bit lighter blue. Rather than mixing white in. Yeah, look at that. Just gonna go do. So, that's done. Now we're going to get a tip full of this color, and we're just going to try and dot the eye of the bird here, like that. And like that. Get a little bit more yellow. And we're going to do the beak and the feet of the bird here. I want these to be a nice, just a nice orange. Not going to overdo it. I'll definitely leave this. Do that shading in there. flip the model upside down to get to a couple places here. Just a little tinge of orange to the eye. Back over this way. Get that right foot. Add a little bit more orange to that. Just to make it shine a little bit more. Dot of orange on these rings. Okay, I can put some of these away now. Away with you. Let's see the color I was gonna grab here. I can't remember where the color was gonna grab. Doesn't matter right now, it's fine. Got our little turquoisey color here. Take a little bit of this and a little bit of our yellow green here. Now we're gonna start mixing some colors. We've got our bloodstain red. Okay, we've got crimson red. And then we're gonna do some clotted red, carnage red, and then fresh blood. That's gonna be for the little tabard piece that he's wearing. That was a little too much. I have to find a figure to use some red on here. Probably do that. Carnage red. Try painting the nozzle here. We need a little bit of that. Make sure I don't have any paint on my hands here. And we're going to go in and we're going to paint the rest of this section. See, if you blow on it, it dries pretty quick too. I'm just doing little hash marks now. Because I want to give this a look like fabric and not just a flat surface, flat red surface. Get right into the fresh blood here. And we're going to go in and do the same thing here. Probably a little hard to tell on the camera, but there are little hash marks on there. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of this orange that we made up, like so. Because I didn't want to go pink. Yeah, we'll take a little bit of orange, we'll take a little bit of the pink. Pink's gonna be pretty overpowering. We're just gonna, oh, that's okay, that's not too bad. I can add a little bit more red into that. size 0. To do some even smaller little hash marks here. And a little bit more pink, because I want it to look a little bit faded, like it's an older piece of garment. So now we're going to start. Doing little tiny hashes here. There. That looks a little bit more like faded thread or fabric. Take a little bit of black Templar. This is a contrast paint here. And we're just going to do the wicks on the candles with this. this away. I should probably keep that up for my other project that I'm working on. Now we're going to grab some other candlelight, which is a very white, off-white, pale yellow. Just gonna add that into our golden yellow here. Like so. I'm just gonna kinda hit the tops. This. I'm going to add a little bit to the candles too, or to the candle flame. I got a little tarnished brass here for the egg. Definitely gonna have to let that dry. Then I think I'm gonna hit it with a flesh wash. So while we wait for that, we're gonna do the base. I've got some coal black here, so what we're going to use on the base. I'm going to be doing some marbling on it. So we're starting with a base of black, then we're going to be moving on to a dark green, some up to lighter greens, and then a nice pale green marble, pale green and white. It's all right if we do a couple coats of this, as long as we get a good coat on here first and let it dry. Okay, I'm going to mute my mic for a second because I want to dry this off real quick with my dryer. So hold on here just a moment. Okay, we're going to go and give, since that's relatively dry now, we're going to give it one more coat of our charcoal black here. Because I really want a nice matte black color. So once we start adding in the green, it's really going to make that. We're going to need the black because it's going to be our main shadow color. So I'm going to spill everything here. That black base is exactly what I was going for, because once we start putting that green over the top of it, it's going to really pop. That green is just going to just explode off of that base with that dark charcoal black over the top of it. If you guys didn't mind a little Duran Duran there. I like them. They're fun. Redo some of that black anyway here. So now we're just gonna look at that. Oh, there we go. And once that dries, maybe I'll actually add a little gold. Do some gold on the egg. That looks good. Just a little bit. All right, I need to find. Do I still have sponge? That one, and I need that one. Do I do three? That's the turquoise. That's the turquoise. Oh. Well, I've got that there. Nat 20 Academy, how are ya? What's happening? Alright, so we've got our Hunter Green, our Green Isle, and our Jade Green. That's how we're going to paint the base. If you guys never seen this before, this kind of blew my mind when I first saw it. I was like, are you using a sponge on a mini? You've had better days. Apartment has a leak, got a crack in the ceiling. Oh no! No! Okay, I am going to move this over there because I need to keep this flat. No picking this up. Okay. Well, I hope to get that fixed. That stinks, man. I'm actually going to tear another little bit off of it. So we're going to grab, this is our Hunter Green. This is actually just a hobby paint from Delta Ceram Coat. And we're going to stick our sponge right into it, like so. We're going to dab a little bit off. So you almost can't see it. And then we're just going to go to town on this base. We're just going to start splotching green all over this base. like so. Probably should have done this before I glued him onto the base. Forethought. What's that? I got none. Get it right in there. You can kind of see it. Landlord was ever said he'll be fixing it tomorrow. Sponge painting, it sounds like a fun texture experiment. It is. I've done this a couple of times with floors and statues and stuff, and I really like the marble effects that it gets. You really like the tones I got on his face. That's pretty. Thank you. Yeah, I was going for a bronze Dragonborn, so I used the bronze skin tone from Reaper with a little bit of green tone and some turquoise bluish green sample color that I have. Okay, now I didn't get all the way in there, so I need to grab a little bit more on like this corner spot here. So like that. Like I said, we're gonna dab a little bit off. And just a little bit. Go in like so. And if I have to go in and use my brush, I will, but I really don't want to. Looks like I might have to though, because the paint's not quite. Well, maybe. Go right back in there. Yeah, exactly. It gives him a little bit more of a Pantina look to him. He did that with a gold dragon? Cool. Yeah, it just makes that skin a little bit more interesting to look at rather than just skin tone or just doing bronze. The color bronze. I mean, these guys, yeah, they're metallic dragons, but Dragonborn are a little bit different breed than regular dragons. So they got a little more real, well, I can't say real skin, but like they're not metallic-y skinned individual. Okay, so that is our hunter green. That part is done. Like I said, I really should have done this before I glued him on. That's fine. Okay, so now we're going to go with our green aisle. This is what the green aisle looks like. It's a much brighter green. We're just going to dab that off onto our paper towel here. And then we start dabbing it onto our base. Just random. Doesn't have to be succinct here at all. It's not. Even the pattern that we're going to get with the marble isn't going to be perfect, because it doesn't need to be, it's stone. Just like so. And now we're going with jade green. This is going to be our final highlight, basically. I'm trying to get into the light here so I can see exactly where I need to go with some of this, because there's still a lot of black. I may have to use my brush to get in a couple places here. Do the border of the base like this too. Give it some consistency. Right. Which con, Nat 20? Is that Rage Con? I think you were promoting Rage Con, right? Yeah, Rage Fan Con. I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it this year. I was looking into it, and I don't know. Wife keeps planning stuff on weekends, so especially during the summer. There's certain friends and family members that we only see during summer months because they filter away during the winter, or they're hard to get to. Yeah, I say as you go on, you know, I'll definitely, you know, stick with the Discord, and I definitely want to see how you're growing and such. So I think if it was more than just one day, that would draw my attention more. I'm thinking just as vendor-wise, if I wanted to come up there and sell stuff. I like it to be more than just one day. Make it a little bit more worth my while coming up there to do so. If I was just coming up there as a patron, might be a fun weekend to do that too, but... All right, so I took my dry brush and got into some of those areas that needed to be gotten. You'll add a streamer channel so that it's easier for people like you to promote. I appreciate that. As to the one day thing, there's already talks about the logistics of making it a full weekend. Nice. There you go. Okay. So, for my next little bit of brush magic here, grab this. Yeah, I figured I'd try and promote a little bit on your Discord. Just because I don't know how many people up in the Iron Range know about this type of stuff. I'm sure there's quite a few, but you know, who's around to teach anybody or to share in the hobby, you know, per se. All right, so I got a pretty good amount on there. So this actually has a design on it. So I'm gonna hopefully get the design going here. So you got that. Oh, there's only two game shops around, Virginia and Duluth Superior. Having folks like you as part of the community is a blessing. Oh, well, thank you, man. Appreciate that. Yeah, I just want to teach people, and hopefully people will enjoy the hobby and get into it. And so I've really got this watered down because I want it to flow really easily. Well, thank you, Nat 20. I appreciate that. I will do so. Greatly appreciate that. So, like I said, as you can see, there is a design. I think he's standing on a pentagram. Not a huge fan of the pentagram, but, you know. Not my sculpt. And I'm also trying to find the little runes that are carved in here, too. If I can find them, I'm going to pick them out. Yeah, it's close to classic occult image. Yeah, absolutely. Arcane imagery. Oh, I have my dragon head that I painted in the Convergence Art Show this last weekend. Didn't sell. Probably priced it too high, but oh well. It's going to travel around with Giant Turtle Creations for the summer, so maybe somebody will want to buy it there. Convergence has been going on now for like, I don't know, 30 some odd years. It's down at the Hyatt Regency Hotel and Convention Center in downtown Minneapolis. And it's... there is some gaming that happens there. Mostly it's a lot of panels and party rooms and stuff like that. So there is like board games and card games and stuff in a decent size dealer's hall. I think they can do more with the dealer's hall. I think they need to add more vendors to it, because everything seems to be kind of clumped in the center of the hall, where they could have more people, literally like tables on the outside on the actual walls, and then have another inner ring of vendors. Oh, you honestly don't think artists at cons charge enough? Cool, I'll have to make some time to catch that. The only other one I've hit down that way was Anime Detour. Yeah, Anime Detour, I think, is coming up here in another couple of weeks or so. I think it's in August. And then there's Minicon. One, I think that's coming up pretty quick too. So, why is this camera all messed up? Get over here. You, there, that's better. Why is it doing that? Oh, because it's there. Aha. I have fixed you. There we go. Another one that is coming up in October that my wife and I are going to go to is Gamehole Con in Madison, Wisconsin. Pretty excited about that one. I haven't been to that one yet. So, looking forward to doing that. So I'm going to grab a turquoise here. I can put these away. Away with you. And I want to grab a solid white. Oh, you've had a few friends hit that one. It seems to have a good rep. One of these days I won't be working so much, you can visit more. Yeah. Yeah, Gamehole Con is in October, and then Gary Con is in March. And in between those two, there's Con of the North down in Plymouth. Gary Con's pretty cool. It's that takes place in Lake Geneva, Wisconsin. The birthplace, supposedly, of D&D. At least that's where the Gygaxes grew up. So, of course, they're calling that the birthplace of D&D, even though Dave Arneson was from here in the Twin Cities. I need my demeanor. That's what I need. Gary Con's fun. I've been twice. My wife and I went. That's where I met my friend Charles Urbach. He's a super cool artist. He's done work for Magic the Gathering, Legend of the Five Rings, Star Wars card game. He's done some work for Origins Game Fair for like their banners and stuff. And all of his work is done in colored pencil. It's amazing. We have a lot of his pieces around the house. All right. So, now that we've got our liner all full up of turquoise here, now we're going to start random lines. So it's going to start, I don't know if you can see it. Oh, you can barely see it. It's very light. It's very subtle. Just little lines to make it look marble. That's going to be the hard part. I'm generally a very quiet person unless I have to run a panel or a game. It can be difficult meeting new people. Yeah, I hear you. I'm definitely a... I always call myself an extroverted introvert. Like, I don't mind meeting new people. But I definitely, afterwards, like, I'll be just socially spent. And it takes me, like, a couple of days to just decompress. Like, yesterday we were at Convergence because I wanted to see, we wanted to see my friend Charles because he was a vendor there, and so we went down there. We actually met him on Friday night. We went out and had supper, and then we went down there because we wanted to see the vendor hall, and then we were also going to help him tear down his booth. So we did that, and then after we were done, we went to dinner, just my wife and I. And I told her, I'm like, okay, that's enough people for a while. Hit some of these. I weren't getting any color on them. You're a huge sufferer of the imposter syndrome and permanent wallflower. Yeah, I'm sorry. I get it. And now for 3 days of isolation so I can recharge. Yes. Yes, 3 days of isolation so I don't have to talk to anybody for a very, very long time. The only problem with that, though, is the job that I currently have. I am on the phone trying to fix people's problems and get technicians out to go repair wheelchairs and stuff, so I don't get that luxury of total isolation. I had thought about being a vendor this weekend down at a place called Hidden, Minnesota. They have weekends and stuff like that where people come and do little market places and stuff, but my wife was like, hey, we're gonna be doing this and this and this all weekend, you might not want to do that. I thought about it and was like, yeah, I'm probably not gonna want to do that, spend all of this weekend. I also had game night on Saturday, so I was really really, really tapped out of my social battery by Sunday night. Which is fine, I came down here and streamed and, you know, got stuff done, but okay, so let's see if I can show this to y'all. So I've used that turquoise to do a bunch of little lines and such. Now I'm going to add a little bit of white into that turquoise and go over it again. So I want it to pop a little bit more. And I want it to be that kind of more pale green color. Here we go. No, I'm just kind of going for some marbling. That's what I'm going for here. So you can kind of see that. And I think what I'm going to do is take a little bit of this white, mix it into this little blue right here. think we're good. I think I need to fix up the robe back here a little bit, though, because I got some... Oh, no. Is it drying out on me? Got some green on it back here. I need to fix it. Too many people are going to be looking at the back anyway, so. Well, there's our marble with the pentagram inside there. Let's see. So, what I do is eyes. Take a little bit of this green here, I think. There. Right there. Size 0 here. Well, it is kind of nice that he is, you know, large-ish. But I appreciate that. Thank you. It definitely helps that he's a bigger figure. Bigger than I thought he was going to be when I first saw him. I was talking with the artist and the sculptor, because they're two different people. One guy, Max Dunbar, did the artwork for it, and then Bruno Costa Simeo from Portugal did the 3D render. And I was like, guys, I'd love to paint that. And Bruno was like, I will send you a copy. And I said, I will paint the copy. Gracie here. I'm going to grab our 0.005 micron pen. I just draw a little line right there. Oh, come on. Come on. So you can see it. It's right there. Yeah, it was super cool. I'm glad I was able to meet those guys on Twitter. It was really neat to be able to chat with them and set that up. So it took like a month for this guy to arrive from Portugal. But definitely worth the wait. It was a ton of fun. And I don't think I can do any more damage to it. I had wanted to do object source lighting coming from the candles onto his head. I really don't want to mess it up. I'm not that great at object source lighting, like I've said before. I think if I'd had a second copy and tried it on that, like a different way before starting to paint it, I might have done it that way, but I think right now I'm just gonna maybe leave it alone. Or if I can, I'm gonna try something. Where is it? So that's my candlelight yellow. In with my other candlelight yellow because I want it to be subtle. Yeah, I've only done it successfully a couple of times. So let's see, this is going to be coming right through here, so we want to put. And I've been trying to watch my friend James Wapple do it. I still don't know how he does it. Just little hints of yellow. Right in through there. Do a little bit on the metallic egg. Just a little bit though, nothing crazy. Nothing on the bird. Everything else, let's see, everything in the light should be going this way. So maybe the bird would get just light reflection. Of the feathers there. There, that's all I'm doing. It's very subtle, but it's there. All right. There is our Dragonborn wizard. He is done. I'm calling him done. This is episode 7 of this guy. I'm calling him done. So I'm going to get some photos of him. I'll throw them up on all the social medias that I'm on. And I'll tag Max and Bruno on Twitter and Instagram for that too. You'd say that's a centerpiece to a collection? Thank you. Yeah. I've got some other ones that I've done that are definitely bigger. I got like 30 plus hours into them. This guy here, let's see, I think I got 4, 7. The first couple ones were like 4 hours and 3 hours long. I did 7 episodes, so 4, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17 hours into him. Yeah, 17 hours. Whew. I think that's enough. All I know is I'm done with him. I'm not going to muck about anymore with him. Then it just gets to being just silly. Putting some of these colors away here. Well, thank you all for joining me on that journey. I greatly appreciate it. I've got some figures that I have to get done before the 27th of July, so I'm going to bust those out real quick and get them to their owner. I don't know what I'm going to paint next on stream, but I'm sure I'll figure it out. Out of the way for a second. There we go. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Like I said, I appreciate it. I'll be back on Sunday with some more stuff. Like I said, don't know what I'm going to paint yet, but I got a ton of stuff. I've got a Song of Ice and Fire figures to paint. I have my friend Amber's stuff to paint as well, so I'll probably get those primed up and ready to go. Which I have to do, I have to try and figure out how to put orange and purple in those paint schemes, so that should be interesting. But, yeah, I'll be back on Sunday, folks, so thanks a lot. Nat20, thank you so much for popping in. I really, really do appreciate people come in and chatting and stuff. So, Commander Root, Elysian, saw the guys ran, Ziki, appreciate it. And we will see you on Sunday. Happy painting, folks. Bye.